and welcome. You've logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, UK, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Rahul Parmar and today's headlines are: in India, the cabinet has approved 10% quota for the economically weaker upper caste. And India has scripted history by winning the first ever test series in Australia. In UK, PM Theresa May will hold parliamentary Brexit vote on January 15th. A new long-term NHS plan can save 5 lakh lives. In Punjab, CM Amrinder Singh has met Congress President Rahul Gandhi, and senior Supreme Court lawyer H.S. Phulkar is set to end the alleged politicization of the SGPC. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, UK and Punjab. For detailed news and businesses updates of the Indo-UK community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: the centre has approved a 10% reservation for the economically backward among the general category in government jobs and admission to higher education institutions. The development comes within hours of the Union Cabinet sanctioning the reservation. India has beaten Australia in the 4-Test series 2-1 after the Sydney Test ended in a draw due to bad weather. This is the first ever Test series win by the visitors against the Aussies in Australia. President Ramnath Kovind and PM Narendra Modi hailed the Indian cricket team's triumph. India has forecast that its economy will grow more than 7% in the current financial year ending in March. This will give some relief to PM Narendra Modi, who seeks a second term in national elections to be held in May. The slugfest between government and Congress on the Rafale deal has intensified. Union Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad has stated that Congress President Rahul Gandhi's angst on the deal was inspired by an ulterior motive of commercial interest. Chief Election Commissioner Sunil Arora has said that EVMs are tamper-proof and an expert committee is looking after their functioning. His remarks come in the backdrop of several political parties in the past alleging that EVMs are prone to tampering. The AGP is pulling out a BJP-led coalition government in Assam over the Citizenship Amendment Bill. It stated that its last-ditch attempt to convince the centre to withdraw the proposed legislation had failed. The Supreme Court has issued a notice to Anil Ambani on a contempt play by Ericsson India Private Limited. It sought initiation to contempt proceedings against the chairman of Reliance Communication Limited, RCOM, for allegedly not complying with its orders to clear dues of rupees 550 crore towards the completion of the asset sale with Reliance Jio Infocom Limited. In fresh trouble for Congress leader Sonia Gandhi's son-in-law Robert Vadra, the ED has filed a money laundering case against a firm allegedly linked to him and a few others. This is in connection with suspected financial and other irregularities in 90s in Gurugram in 2008. National carrier Air India has defaulted on salary payment for the second consecutive month, missing the December payday amid liquidity crunch. Air India had failed to pay to its over 20,000 employees on time for most of the months last year. Actress Anushka Sharma is over the moon after the historic series win of the Indian cricket team in Australia. She says that she is proud of her husband Virat Kohli, who led the team in the four-match series that India claimed 2-1. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as news from UK and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from UK are: PM Theresa May will hold a delayed parliamentary vote on her Brexit deal on January 15. May was forced to pull the vote on her deal in December after she said that it will be defeated by a large majority. NHS bosses in England have said that a new 10-year plan can save up to 5 lakh lives by focusing on prevention and early detection. Mental health and community care will get the biggest funding increase to shift the focus away from hospitals. Conservative MP Anna Sobre briefly stopped a live interview in Westminster as protesters chanted, "Sobre is a Nazi." The protesters had been previously calling her a liar, and she was talking to Simon McCoy on the news channel. Ads for a Britain's first petition to stop a mosque being built in Maidstone appeared on Facebook over the Christmas period. Despite the group being banned by social networks, the three ads and the page on which they originated have now been removed. Welsh First Minister Mark Drakeford had campaigned to stay in the EU if matters was put again to public in a new referendum. However, Drakeford's support for a fresh poll remains conditional on Brexit deal failing to pass MPs and no election taking place. HSBC has been criticised for an advertising campaign that claims UK is not an island. The campaign created by agency J. Walter Thompson is described as campaigning the idea that we are all global citizens amid uncertainty around Brexit. A group has said that up to a quarter of students are doing degrees that will not give them sufficient earnings to justify the cost of their loans. The group has urged ministers to cut finance on education, which will pay less students in the future. Scottish First Minister Nicola Sturgeon has said that MPs have a duty to come up with an alternative to Prime Minister Theresa May's Brexit deal. She has called for the Labour Party to join other opposition groups in backing a new referendum on Brexit. Crystal Palace keeper Wayne Hennessy has denied making a Nazi salute during a meal with his teammates. Hennessy was pictured with his right arm in the air in a photo posted on Instagram by Palace midfielder Max Meyer, who is German. British stars Olivia Colman, Christian Bale, Richard Madden and Ben Whishaw were among the winners at this year's prestigious Golden Globe Awards. Colman was honoured for the film The Favourite and Bale won for playing ex-US Vice President Dick Cheney in Vice. I'll be back, stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily, the top 10 headlines from Punjab are. CM Amrinder Singh has met Congress President Rahul Gandhi regarding the upcoming Lok Sabha election. Singh told Rahul that there was no need for an alliance with the Aam Aadmi Party in the state. He ruled out need for an alliance, calling the party defunct. Senior Supreme Court lawyer H.S. Phulka has said that he will form a group to end the alleged politicization of the SGPC. Phulka said that the people from the group will not contest the SGPC election. Sukhpal Khaira, who quit the Aam Aadmi Party recently, has said that he will announce his party soon. Khaira said that the Punjab Democratic Alliance formed by them in December will meet later to decide on seat sharing for the Lok Sabha election. Human Resource and Development Minister Prakash Javadekar has said that the country is working to address the problem of lack of research. Javadekar made the statement while speaking at the 106th Science Congress at Lovely Professional University. Health and Family Welfare Minister Brahm Mohindra has said that the first draft of the Clinical Establishment Act is ready and will be adopted soon. Mohindra also requested cooperation from doctors of the Indian Medical Council and the Punjab Medical Council to implement the act. Delhi's Deputy CM Manish Sisodia has accused former Aam Aadmi Party leader and MLA Sukhpal Singh Khaira of trying to weaken the party. Khaira has recently resigned from the party. Gurdaspur Congress MLA Barinder Meet Singh Thara led a delegation of 80-odd party and cleared all trash from PM Narendra Modi's rally venue. Modi had held a rally in January 3rd, following which a trail of trash was left at the venue. Ahead of the Lok Sabha elections, the state Congress has begun to exercise to dole out political appointments to its legislator and senior party leaders. The names for appointments of chairmen in boards and corporations besides other bodies will be announced soon. Minister Tripp Rajinder Singh Bajwa has questioned PM Narendra Modi for claiming credit for the conviction of former Congress leader Sajjan Kumar in the 1984 anti-Sikh riots case. Tripp claimed that Sajjan was convicted on the appeal of the UPA. Bengal will face a star-studded Punjab in their do-or-die Ranji Trophy Elite Group B clash. Punjab look forward to former Indian all-rounder Yuvraj Singh, who will look to make an impact both with the bat and ball. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resource section of this portal to find the best Indo-UK businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Produced by Suresh Oberoi and Sandeep S. Singh, the film titled PM Narendra Modi has released its first look. Actor Vivek Oberoi plays the titular role of 14th Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi. As per critic Dharinder Ardarsh, the first look poster was unveiled in 23 languages by Maharashtra CM Devendra Fadnavis. Directed by Umang Kumar, the film will go on floors in the coming days. The film's team has been working on the project for the past 2 years. Known for the films like Ishqiya, Dher Ishqiya and Urta Punjab, director Abhishek Chaubey brings a story based on Rebels of Chambal region titled Son Chiraiya, the trailer of which is released today. The decoy drama features Sushant Singh Rajput and Bhumi Pednekar in the lead roles. The trailer depicts inter-gang wars between the decoy groups, fighting to acquire control of Central India back then. The movie also stars Manoj Bajpayee, Ranveer Shorey and Ashutosh Rana. Early in 2012, a similar story on Rebel Pan Singh Tomar was well appreciated by the audience. Son Chiraiya is set to hit theatres on February 8, 2019. Varun Dhawan and Shraddha Kapoor are roped in for a dance-based film which will be helmed by choreographer Emo D'Souza. Varun and Shraddha will again be sharing the screen space for a new dance flick. Produced by Bhushan Kumar, Krishan Kumar and Lizelle D'Souza, the film will begin shooting from 22nd January 2019 in Punjab. The major portion of the film will be shot in UK. The official announcement is made by film critic Tarun Adarsh. Varun also tweeted along with the picture with co-star Shraddha. Welcome home, Chirkut. Earlier, he gave hint to the upcoming film and tweeted, "Really getting pushed by all my trainers. Announcement coming soon." The title of film and other details are kept under wraps. On actress Bipasha Basu's 40th birthday on Monday, her husband and actor Karan Singh Grover took to social media and shared a heartwarming message thanking her for making his life beautiful and complete. Karan tweeted on Sunday night, "It's the best day of the year again. Happy birthday, my love, Bipasha. Thank you for being born and making my life so beautiful and complete." The Raaz actress took to her Instagram account where she shared a video of herself blowing the candles. She captioned the video, "I love my birthdays. I live this awesome life full of love thanks to this day. Well, all the emotions do kick on my birthday, but the focus continues to stay on the cakes and the biryani. It's a ritual." A string of Bollywood celebrities too took to Twitter to wish Bipasha. Here's what they have tweeted. Abhishek Bachchan, "Happy birthday, Bippy. Always keep smiling." Deya Mirza wrote, "I love this girl, Bipasha. I wish you a bright, beautiful year ahead." Dinu Moria wrote, "Happiest birthday, Bipasha. Wish you lots of love and happiness." Preeti Jacinta tweeted, "Happy birthday to Bipasha. Wish you loads of love, happiness and success always." Actor Aamir Khan, who keeps altering his looks according to what his films demand, says he is now on a strict diet to get in shape for his next project. Aamir interacted with the media at a Sunday brunch. Asked about how his usual Sunday brunch, he said,
"Sunday brunch ki shuruaat pehle to main kafi kuch karta tha, lekin ab main kafi strict diet pe hu. For my next film. So I've started getting back into shape."
Refusing to disclose the name of the film for which he has started training, Aamir said,
"No, I cannot tell you which one it is, but it's for my new film. I'm getting back into shape, yeah."
He was out for a brunch with his daughter Ira Khan. Aamir's last big screen appearance was in Thugs of Hindustan.